Okay, so that tune was called Nothing. And what we're going to do is start the show, start the event now. And I'm going to introduce Alex Pascall to you. But before I do that, the people who are here, what we do is we have a registration form if you're interested in workshops that we have going on. Okay, the workshops are going to be every Saturday. And the form's there. And it's for young people and adults. Okay, we've got workshops, which is 12 weeks long. And what you do is you can sign up and it's totally free. And what you do is you come and you learn to play steel pans and you learn also about some of the history of the Caribbean music. Okay? So, and if you want those forms, speak to brother on the right there. Okay? If you'd like to fill in. I'd like to introduce you to Alex Pascall. Okay, who is formerly a Radio London host, and he had the show for many, many years, and is a very great influence and a great person of the community who we're going to have to give us a compare for the day.
I want to celebrate, nevertheless, the advancement we have made as a people of African Caribbean descent, because Britain did not get rid of slavery, the slaves themselves got rid of it. And why I'm saying so, it is because the steel band in the movement of African people and the rhythmic form that was brought to the Caribbean that is today across the world is due to the innovative factors of a Caribbean people. And let me define that for you, please. Because when we all came to Britain, Britain only knew one island in the Caribbean, Jamaica. What the steel band has done to date is to put the geography of the Caribbean and the rest of the Caribbean countries, its rhythmic culture and other forms into world perspective. The Caribbean is very wide. We call it the Caribbean Basin within the Americas. I must give you this piece of geography for the history to settle down, for the pan to come forward, and for us to know where we are on this eve of what is to us very relevant. If you look at Jamaica up in the north, it's 1,100 miles from Trinidad and Tobago down in the south. The Caribbean is big. When I bring Gerald, Forsyth to talk about the music, you will see how wide the influences of the music is. If you look at the languages of the Caribbean beginning from the top, you will see Jamaica branding its own type of language. Best person to take up for that in history is Louise Bennett. Nobody can beat her on that. If you go across to the Bahamas, 700 islands, it's like if they don't belong to us, but we're all the Caribbean. Because America more or less, the United States more or less occupies that. If you look at Haiti, where the first revolution, successful revolution against Europe took place, Haiti, speaking French. If you look at Cuba, the Dominican Republic, you get Spanish. And I can take you across into the Leewards, Martinique, Guadeloupe, Dominica, Saint Lucia, where French Creole, the type of language that will come into the Calypso idiom, which would bring forward part of the steel band movement and the Calypso of the Caribbean. I said Calypso, I never said soca. That's a different thing. The music will vary from the top right down to the bottom. But one thing that is dominant is the fact that the African rhythms have remained as the most formative part of Caribbean music. You cannot run away from that at all. It is dominant. And I want, while the steel band is going to do little bits and pieces of demonstration of certain forms of rhythms and songs that has come through the period from the time when the steel band developed to where it is in Europe and across the world, I would like to introduce one of the people who have come to England after the steel band came to England, because the steel band landed here officially in 1951. I have a feeling, and I've never spoken to Gerald Forsyth about that, that somewhere or the other the time could have been here before 1951, and I like to throw up things like that so we could provoke each other. And my reason of saying that is because World Wars I and II brought people playing percussive instruments. And there might have been something in the development that I know about, that Gerald might know about, that we never spoke about. And I have other fine people here today. So it's a lovely day for you who want to play steel band, or steel band in particular, and who want to learn a little bit more about the music of the Caribbean, to hear us, and a few of us, who have come through the history to talk about it. Gerald has written, and has written as a pan man, the first book on pan written by a Trinidadian pan man in Britain. The word first, we are being very careful with it, because some people will say, I do that first, I do this first and second. I've been around, and I know Terry Noel wrote another book, and I don't want people to go away wrong, but it has never been as representative as this one is of a person who has been, there was never an inspector of steel bands in schools before Gerald Forsyth. And Gerald will go into the rest of what we cover here. Would you put your hands together, please, and welcome Gerald Forsyth.
Oh, okay, I get what you mean. Like that. Same.
Yes. During the time, it was not accepted by the people of the land because it came from the ghetto. And there was a music festival in about St. James, Trinidad. And the first prize was a bicycle. This man was there tonight. From then we had other competitions, but what made pants being accepted in Trinidad after is because the university boys started playing. My mom never wanted me to play. And likewise, all the young people did, the family didn't want them to play. But as soon as, I have to speak the truth, as soon as the lights came, Trinidad and start playing, the university people playing, then it was accepted. We move from there. And as Mr. Pascall will show you, who do not know the geography of the Caribbean, the little ones look at it. That's what he was talking about. That's the geography of the Caribbean. We used to have, therefore, by having steel band competition, it will improve the standard of the bands. So we used to have a music festival every 2 years. The first year was 1952. And a young man won the festival. They must be a winner. They skipped it for 2 years. But during that time, we were so British. The greatest of all for me and many people, his name is Elliot Manette. We call him Ellie. He's working in, now, the man who invented pan, as I say, there may be some controversy and the man may say it's him, but this man explained to me how it happened, and I'm going. His name is Winston Spree Simon. The instrument that you all play now was invented by this man. He died about 8 years ago. Pascall. It's nice to know history. That's the man who invented it. We have another inventor also. During those years, people used to come to the Caribbean, they call them tourists. So this man started making miniature pans, selling to the tourists. And I went to a conference at East London University in September. And a German guy of the age of 30 to 35 came to the conference showing the small pan, he invented it. So I had to show him this. This man died last year in an accident. He was 71. And look at how young he was when he invented these small pans. And a German coming out and saying he invented it. So history is always wrong. Mr. Pascall explained the first steel pan that was recorded coming to England. So it's called TASPO, made in Trinidad All-Star Percussion Orchestra in 1951. And that was the band. And that's how we used to play the steel pan many years ago. Yes, this song they're about to play was composed by a Cuban. His name was Perez Prado. And during the period of the 40s up to the 60s, every band in the Caribbean used to play that type of music. It's called mambo. And he composed maybe about 100. And his songs were hit in England, in America, all over the world. One of the bands that I'm sure that you all heard on the radio is called Mambo 5. Mambo. You hear that in England, but that's a first try. So this one is called, this one upcoming is Mambo in F.
Thank you. You may be as high and sophisticated, but when carnival time comes, you're winding your waist down and out. Whether you're the doctor, the lawyer, or anybody else, you're part and parcel of that society. And what he has done is to create his, and that's the only pan-podium that is today as a magazine in representation of the steel pan. I want to introduce him to speak to you. Give him a round of applause.
But now, in a panyard, we have musicians, pan musicians. We always had pan musicians. The society saw pan men as hooligans. Okay? And I'm really, really proud to look at the youths today to see them play pan. You know? Keep up the work. That's what it's good. Yeah? And introduce the pan to your colleagues as well. Yeah? That's the way it spreads. Okay? I'm also a director of the British Association of Steel Bands, and the magazine I like to talk to you about is an idea I came up with. Okay? Because I used to write for, I don't know if you remember a publication called Super News at one time here. And I used to write for them. And I developed a page called Down in the Panyard, which highlighted what steel bands was doing in the UK. And with the help of the British Association of Steel Bands and the Arts Council, we were able to develop Pan-Podium magazine, which is the official magazine of the British Association of Steel Band. It's also got a website. Okay? It highlights what hard work these people do, the elders, as well as the young people. Okay? It does just the pan people, it's the people in the background, not just people who play, the musical arrangers, the people who are the management in pan. That's what it's all about. As a director of the British Association of Steel Bands, I'll talk a little bit about BAS. It was established in December 1995 as a successor to the London Brotherhood of Steel. And it represents British steel bands to further the musical, artistic, and educational, social aspects of the art form. That's what the association is there for. The association is run by an elected management committee. And membership is open to all steel bands in Britain, to individual members and other interested parties. The organisation assists with the provision of training in arranging, playing, performing, management, administration, marketing, publicity and fundraising. We also provide information on all aspects of the steel band and steel bands. We promote the history, culture and the music of the art form. We also organize concerts, festivals, and shows, and we act as a booking agency. So if you want a steel band to play, wherever you need, just contact the BAS. We will put you in touch with a steel band in your area. We are funded by the Arts Council of England, and we have an annual program of events, which includes Pan Explosion. And with us today is a young lady called Delphina James. She's sitting in front here with me, and she is the actual chairperson of our Future Development Forum. The association has actually created what we call a young open executive committee, and we're actually training them and assisting them and guiding them to be our successors. So they take over the association money. The whole movement lies with the youth. You've got to promote the art form with them, and that's where they continue.